Dahil ang pagkatuto ay di natatapos sa loob ng paaralan, samahan nyo kami sa isa namang mainit na talakayan.
Ating pag-usapan ang mga hashtag trending issues na bibigyan natin ng kalinawan.
Kaya naman, schoolmates, sit back, relax, at enjoy this alternative classroom learning experience with your coolest barkada. Dito lang sa
Schoolmates!
Paalala pong muli sa ating mga kababayan, lagi po tayong mag-ingat at maging aware sa panahon ng pandemya. Sinusulungan ng DOH, Department of Health, ang Bida Solusyon COVID-19 upang himukin po ang mga mamamayan to practice preventive measures to fight the COVID-19 pandemic.
That's right, Gab. Maging bida sa paglaban ng COVID-19. Saan man po tayo pumunta, lagi nating alalahanin na B, bawal ang walang mask. I, isanitize ang mga kamay. D, dumistansya ng 1 metro. At A, alamin po ang tamang impormasyon.
Ugaliin na natin ang mga paalalang ito at responsibilidad natin bilang mamamayan ng bansang ito na maging alerto at maagap sa ating sitwasyon ngayon. Umpisahan natin sa ating mga sarili ang pag-iingat para sa mga mahal natin sa buhay at para na rin sa ikuulan ng ating bansa.
Schoolmates, mamaya ating pag-uusapan sa ating hashtag trending kung dapat ba o hindi dapat ipagbawal ang pagsali ng mga menor de edad sa mga full contact competitive sports.
Bukod po dyan, makakapanayam din natin ang isang representative mula sa Philippine Sports Commission upang sagutin ang ilang katanungan tungkol sa larangan ng palakasan.
Para lang hindi lamang mga kabataan ang tinutulungan, kundi maging ang mga magulang, iyan ang inyong tututukan mamaya sa Share Ko Lang. Lahat lang yan ating pag-usapan, kaya naman guys, tutok lang kayo dyan at magbabalik ang
Schoolmates!
Welcome to Hashtag Trending. Labis na naapektuhan ng pandemyang COVID-19 ang larangan ng palakasan. Naantala ang mga sports events and competitions dahil sa protocols upang maiwasan ang pagkalat ng virus at para na rin sa ikababuti ng mga atleta. Ngunit bago pa man ang banta ng pandemya, Hulyo ng nakaraang taon, ipinasa sa Kongreso nina Ako Bicol Representatives Alfredo Garbin Jr. at Elizalde Co. ang House Bill No. 1526. Layunin ng bill na ito na ipagbawal ang pagsali ng mga menor de edad sa mga competitive full contact sports tulad ng boxing, mixed martial arts at iba pang uri ng full contact karate. Isinasaad din sa bill na ito na kinakailangang i-regulate ang partisipasyon ng mga minors sa leisure, non-competitive sports at maging sa training ng mga ito. Nais ng bill na ito na maproteksyonan ang mga menor de edad mula sa injuries na maaaring matamu nila during competitions and other activities. Maraming umalma sa bill na ito, lalo na ang mga atleta at mga personalidad na maapektuhan ng bill. Counterproductive daw ito at naniniwala silang training and development of such skills should start during the early years of the athlete. Kaya naman ang ating hashtag trending topic ay pagbabawal sa pagsali ng mga menor de edad sa full contact competitive sports, dapat o hindi dapat. Para mas maintindihan natin ang ating diskusyon, narito sina Shaira Janis Daraway and Christian Colliado. Sa ating topic ngayon, ilang taon ba yung sinasabi nilang mga menor de edad? So ilang taon pwede makasali sa mga full contact competitive sports? At kung hindi pasok yung edad mo, can you elaborate on us ano itong sinasabing regulation of participation and training?
So we are going to pertain to House Bill 1526, which is the House Bill that aims to ban minors from participating into full contact sports. Now, in order for us to elaborate more, when we call minors, they are people who are age 18 and below. Meaning, if you're ever at the age gap, at the age range of 18 and below, you are not allowed to join competitive full contact sports. But the thing here is, it does not actually prohibit you from practicing the sport itself. Now, under the House Bill, it is stated there that certain full contact sports would be regulated. And how would these regulations be? It would be on the forms of, during training, certain guardians and coaches would be present to act immediately on the purpose of protecting the child if ever that things go overboard during the training. We must understand that full contact sport has tendencies to be violent at times, especially if there are heated arguments between the two sides. We know how children can also be competitive. We know how they hate losing. So by regulating these certain actions during trainings and practices, we can say that this is just one form of regulation. Now, another form of regulation would be the use of protective personal equipment during those trainings. Some of these protective personal equipment includes but are not limited to head pads, body paddings, and certain knee and shoulder pads. Now, we can use this as well as other gloves for us to minimize the impact of the trainings themselves. But we must also know that training is highly different from competition itself.
Shaira, itong mga sinabi ni Christian na mga regulations, hindi ba ito kasalukuyang nangyayari sa status quo natin? And sorry, Shaira, pakisagot na rin, ano-ano ba itong mga sinasabing full contact competitive sports?
What Christian said, according to the context of the House Bill, is relatively accurate in a sense that yes, it's currently being represented in the status quo. And when we're talking about full contact sports, at least the ones that are stated in the provisions are boxing, mixed martial arts, jiu-jitsu, muay thai, judo, and various forms of full contact karate, which yes, it's existing in status quo. But here's the problem in the topic, banning competitive full contact sports and then ensuing the regulation of their trainings and whatnot. Here's the thing, yes, minors participate in full contact sports, but here's the thing, just because this certain type of sport is considered as full contact, it doesn't mean that the activities are automatically sparring, automatically going on the mat and fighting with someone else. There are also other forms of activities under full contact sports that are more suitable for minors, in which we should not ban. Example, I think it's present in Wushu or in other, incorporated in other forms of mixed martial arts, we have where minors are very much encouraged to practice the form, in which there's a lot of competitive categories for that. They also have the empowerment of minors in practicing the props, how to be properly familiarize their body. That is where it's very important to include the youth in competitive comp, at least sa mga menor de edad, to include them in the inculcation of competitive contact sports, because not necessarily all the activities that are present in that category are automatically things that will endanger somebody else. Now, here's the other problem with what Christian said. Well, yes, there should be a regulation in the status quo. That's definitely what's happening now. So if that regulation is properly implemented, just like what's happening today, and even stated in the House Bill, then it really shows that what else would be the reason for you to ban minors from participating in contact sport. I understand that there must be proper guidance, and with proper guidance, which is why it was already stated that we should use the proper personal equipment, we should use proper gears, because that is no longer necessarily full contact physical kind of parang hindi na siya full contact directly on your opponent, but more on partial contact. And this is not only exclusive to minors, but even to actual veterans in mixed martial arts arena or in this full contact sports. It's really mandated for you to use gears, and not necessarily that you're going to blatantly fight each other without having these equipments. Furthermore, even the House Bill aims that it's not necessarily that they believe that this is very dangerous for the youth, but rather you should properly regulate it. So if you're really going to properly regulate it, then I don't really see how it is very necessary to ban it specifically for minors if it's already shown that there are proper precautions and it's not necessary that all categories of full contact sports would be utilized.
Christian, ikaw matanong ko, sa tingin mo, paano ba magbe-benefit dito ang ating mga atleta if we do not allow minors to join competitions? And for you, Shaira, paano naman to hindi makabubuti sa ating mga atleta?
Well, I would have to explain that first and foremost. The reason why this written House Bill was proposed was for us to protect the children, the minors. Dear people, we must understand that minors currently are still currently developing their bodies, meaning they are highly fragile people. Dear people, we must understand that even minor that according to even researches, minor concussions can cause severe damages to those certain individuals even in the future, and it would affect their lives later on. Now, we should also consider the fact that these certain competitive contacts can also cause certain injuries to them that would also affect their certain jobs, in their certain selection of jobs in their future. Like, for example, what if because of that full contact sport, you get an injury that would not allow you to get into PMA, PMA and whatnot? That would highly demoralize the child. Another problem here is that if ever that full contact sport would, if ever that certain participants of the full contact sport would face casualties, there would be two, it would be a double-edged sword towards the victim and towards the other victim, which is the one who accidentally killed or injured his or her opponent. Dear people, this has already happened in the past. Last 2019 in Cuba, a boy died during his taekwondo match. After the finishing blow by his opponent, he just suddenly fell on the floor while his opponent was actually rejoicing his victory. Now, the problem here at the same time is that there are also no first aiders in the vicinity. They weren't actually expecting that certain thing to happen. Another issue here is on the side of the person who accidentally injured or killed his opponent. Dear people, we must understand that while contact sport may bring glory to us and whatnot, we must also prioritize the health of the children in the very first place. Because if we are not going to protect them, then we are going to expose them to the risk of these certain sports. Now, continuing on, another reason why banning competitive contact sport would be good is that we get to give the chance to children to focus on actually honing their skills with the proper sense of competitiveness under the proper guidance of their mentor and not on the field of the competition itself. Dear people, must understand that competition is different from minor sparring. The aura of the competition is different from the aura when you are just in your dojo. When you are in competition, you start to get into the game. And the thing here is that once certain minors get into the game, there would also be the problem and issue of their physical differences. As I've stated, children and minors are still developing their bodies, meaning there would be people who are bigger than their opponents, and that would be a big disadvantage to the other opponents. Now, continuing on, the thing here is that it would not actually negatively impact the athletic association, the athletic culture here in the Philippines, since we are still going to continue on practicing the certain sports, but only under the guidance and regulations of their coaches, masters, parents, and guardians. Meaning, if ever that something bad happens or things get overly heated during their sparrings or in trainings, the coaches and guardians can actually intervene immediately. This is in comparison to when in competitions, the coaches and their guardians can actually intervene because under the rules of competition, they must keep on fighting at no one.
Sorry, maputol kita, Kristen. Ibabato ko yung sinabi mo, Kristen, kay Shaira. Nakapagbanggit ka na sabi mo gusto niyong protektahan ang kalusugan from injuries ang ating mga minors. Now, Shaira, paano naman maapektuhan nito ang mga trainings? For example, ang disciplines and skills na gustong matutunan ng ating mga young athletes?
Yes, Kristen was right in his methodology and goal in addressing that it should properly be for the safety of the youth. But this is where discrepancies happen. You see, when you're talking about implementing agencies, specifically sports implementing agencies that are aimed to protect the safety of these children, or in this case, minors, they're also working in line with the guidelines of the Philippine Olympic Committee, I believe, in which then their guideline is not necessarily based on competitiveness and competitions, but because there is a set standards that these licensed academies or training camps must follow. Now, what happens if you ban them in competitive sports? You are also cutting the ties of these regulations and implementing policies that are put in place through that agreement. While yes, I agree, there are separate and autonomous safety measures that a licensed agency must follow, definitely there wouldn't be a liability extended towards its fullest capacity. Now, let's look onto Christian's anecdotal evidence a while ago about the situation in Cuba. Yes, definitely, we have to understand that there are times where people get injured, even minors, but look at it on an unregulated perspective. positive. There are more people who are getting injured even in trainings and even in unregulated fights, meaning these are fights that are happening outside the institutions. So what happens if you ban them in competitive sports? Well, yes, you're properly regulating them in training, but also how about the discrepancies in terms of this injury? For example, if person A injured person B and he somehow is a member of a competitive or varsitarian mixed martial art camp or academy, what happens? Then there would be more sanctions, there would be more liabilities, and it will be a much further burden for these agencies to properly address that issue once more to the Philippine Olympic Committee. Also, there will be much more legislations or implementing provisions that would further elaborate that, especially in the training grounds. There will be proper sanctions that are not only limited to outside perspectives such as the parents, but also proper sanctions in how these companies operated. Because what happens outside competitive sports, if you're going to ban it, and what happens is you're also going to cut the treaties and the agreements that happen, what's going to happen? Then there will be a limited amount of liability that can be put into these people who are actually using it for detrimental purposes. And okay, all we're right. going to say that...
Shaira and Christian, putulin ko muna kayo. Nagiging mainit na, baka kayo ang magkaratihan dyan at mag-taekwondohan, magsipaan. Before tayo magpatuloy sa ating diskusyon, dumako muna tayo sa ating mga comments ng ating mga netizens. Satin yan sa atin ni Trisha.
Salamat, Sky. Hindi lang mga debaters ang pwede makialam sa issue natin ngayong gabi. Siyempre, maging ang ating mga schoolmates na nanonood sa kanilang mga tahanan ay pwedeng makisali sa ating diskusyon. Kaya naman, aking babasahin ang mga opinyong pinadala ninyo ng ating mga netizens. Uunahin ko na ang sabi ni JV Manukat. I guess, pwede naman basta safe and secure yung mga kalahok. Well sanitized yung mga equipment, that is true. And may negative result yung mga manglalaro and event staff. I guess this is about the COVID testing, no? Sports will boost your immune system. Maraming salamat sa ating mga netizens at patuloy lamang po kayong magpadala ng inyong mga komento at opinion, at maaari rin po kayong bumoto sa ating mga social media accounts kung saan kayo papalik sa ating topic for tonight. Guys, sa aming pagbabalik, ipagpapatuloy natin ang mainitang diskusyon dito lang sa Iskoolmates!
Welcome back to Iskoolmates! Sa pagpapatuloy ng ating diskusyon kung dapat bang ipagbawal ang mga menor de edad na sumali sa mga full contact competitive sports. Debaters, para sa aking susunod na katanungan, ito ituloy na natin, baka kayo nang magbakbakan dyan. Hindi naman kayo minors, no? So pwede kayo dito sa competition na to.
Okay.
No, kanina napag-usapan na natin na ang epekto nitong mungkahin natin sa mga young athletes natin. So ngayon gusto kong puntahan kung ano bang magiging epekto naman sa competitiveness ng ating country in sending representatives sa mga Olympics abroad. So how will this proposal of not allowing minors to join full contact competitive sports impact the probability of our country na manalo sa mga ipapadala nilang mga manlalaro?
So here's the thing. Everyone always has this first time during entering competitions, and it would not be different from most people who would like to enter in the near future. Let us remember that you can be a black belter as early as you are 12 years old, just like Japoy. Now, Japoy got his black belt when he was 10 or 11, and then he went on to compete on international competitions while he was a teenager. But that is not a point here. We must also remember that we can still cultivate these certain players and athletes to become the best version of themselves through the use of national training programs. We have our national sports team, and they would be the people who would support them in the near future. Let us remember that trainings are not prohibited, only competitive full contact sport, meaning they can still train themselves. We can still prepare for the Olympics if ever. We can still prepare for the Olympics, which encompasses people under the age of 21. Now, dear people, you must also understand that other than that, we must we must also take note that this is only a House Bill still as of the moment, meaning there are still things that could be changed within the provisions of the House Bill itself, meaning if ever that we might completely ban competitive sports in the country, it might only be within the parameters of our country itself, meaning you can still send out minors to compete overseas and they would be under the guide of those Philippine national training programs that we have. Remember, we have Philippine teams for boxing, for gymnastics, we have Philippine teams for judo, taekwondo, and their people. Under the guidance of these national teams, we can make sure that we could still produce competent athletes to represent our country. Remember, dear people, even if you do not join competitions, you can actually become a better person. You can enhance your skills, you can enhance what you currently know.
Shaira and Christian, of course, we can see that we want to protect our young athletes. That's why we are proposing this. Pero kulang ba sa tingin ninyo ang ating status quo, ang kasalukuyan na nangyayari sa sitwasyon ng ating mga atleta? Kulang ba o sapat ang mga rules and regulations sa larangan ng sports sa ating bansa upang maproteksyonan natin ang ating mga atleta?
Yeah, we really do believe that we have a long way to go in terms of properly empowering our athletes, not necessarily just on their full contact sports, but on providing proper amenities for them, providing proper representation. In fact, if you're actually a representative of the Philippines, you get granted scholarships for you to study, for you to pursue your education too at the same time, as I think it's depending on the threshold of your prowess, which is very important why we need to have youth representation in competitive sports. Because it's very privileged for us to say that since it's not that much, it doesn't make that much of a big difference to have scholarships for people, because not a lot of students or athletes. It's very privileged for you to say that. And now let's look at if it's going to ban the participation of minors in competitive sports. If we're going to look at Christian's argument, he also stated that the law on prohibition does not necessarily extend towards international competition. So I don't get how that would properly correlate, at least in the way that it would be implemented. Because if that's going to happen, then there will still definitely be training for them, very rigorous training. Second of all, not all members who are most likely going to compete in contact competitive sports, not necessarily these are 6 to 12 years old. Most likely, these are also 15 to 18 years old who are still technically considered minors, but they're already in a stage where they're more qualified. They have the mental capacity to at least act with discernment. And third of all, it is where we could have a proper idea of youth representation. Because if we're going to say that you want to ban ban minors in competitive sports to minimize injury, then you might as well ban them in the training field at the same time, because most of these injuries happen if they're not properly monitored during their training, which is why it's very important to regulate it instead. If you're just going to ban them on competitive sports, then not necessarily on training, it does not eliminate the dangers that come with it. It's simply prohibiting it from being aired on national television, or from it being broadcasted, which is much more detrimental to our youth at the same, which are much more detrimental to our youth at the same time, because there would then be lesser documented cases for these people who have compromised safety precautions. So it's much more important to not cut that tie. At the same time, the selection of those who will participate overseas or in competitive sports are not necessarily just because you're off this age bracket and you could automatically participate. No, there will still be discernment of the coach and licensed agencies and academies of full contact sports who must follow the guidelines and must sign waivers that will allow these people to join in the first place. So what should we do? We should call for accountability not only in competitive sports but even in their training. Because if you're going to cut them in competitive sports, you're also going to cut the implementation of regulating policies by, I believe, the Philippine Olympic Committee that will further help them in protecting their rights. Because if that's going to be cut, then what else is the point of their training? If you can say for leisure activities, then there would be no longer sanctionable violations that are going to happen, because it's not necessarily something that was competitive. It's not necessarily something that was considered harming, because it's only for leisure activities. Then you can see that there is already a discrepancy, or it blurs the guidelines that properly protect these children. So what should we do by further helping them compete? First, youth representation. That's very much important in the status quo today, because we're living in a society where it's so much more invested on your intellectual capability to have to have representation to the world, but we should also look at people who also have their physical prowess, who are able to represent people under regulated circumstances. If their training is very regulated, if you properly follow implementation, then definitely these injuries will not happen and will incredibly lessen, if not be abolished. And if it still happens, then we will have implementing agencies and policies that are present and that are present and in line with the guidance that need to be followed, these academies, that will further safeguard them. That is the best way for us to solve it without compromising youth representation. Because we're going to talk about 6 to 7-year-old minors competing in full contact sports. They're most likely going to join the forms, the how they yield props, and not necessarily sparring or going on the mat. These are more scared for people who are off the upper weight class. And this would act against this would act incongruent to the discernment of those who are really qualified to monitor this, because injuries happen when they are unregulated, Saira, and are unmonitored and undocumented. Thank you.
Maraming salamat, Kristen and Saira. Ako mismo ay maraming natutunan sa ating nangyaring topic for tonight. Marami pa tayong pag-uusapan, Schoolmates. Kaya kapit lang dahil magbabalik ang Schoolmates!
Nagbabalik ang Schoolmates, isa po sa labis na naapektuhan ng pandemyang COVID-19 ang larangan ng palakasan. Marami pong sports events and competitions ang nakansela at di natuloy dahil sa health and safety protocols. At sa pagkakataong ito, makakapanayam po natin mula sa Philippine Sports Commission ang PSI National Training Director, Sir Mark Velasco. Sir, para sa ating unang tanong, kamusta po ang larangan ng paligsahan sa ating bansa noong kasagsagan ng pandemya?
We drafted yung guideline for restarting sports in a COVID environment. So, nung dinaf natin, it was recognized by the IATF, and consequently, nagpulong po yung Philippine Sports Commission, Department of Health, and the Games and Amusements Board. So, naglabas po kami ng joint administrative order which outlines guidelines po on restarting some sports in this time of the pandemic. So, up to now, yun po yung basis natin. Fast forward now, some of the sports po inallow ng IATF to practice. Sama na po dyan yung cycling, skateboarding, badminton, tennis, golf. So yung mga sports na po yun ay nagsimula na pong pwedeng gawin sa time ng pandemic. Pero pinagbabawal pa rin po natin yung pagkakaroon ng competition ng isang particular sport. So organizing any events po ay pinagbabawal pa po. Tapos on the part of the amusement sports, although PSC kami, but we work closely sa joint administrative order, pinayagan po yung professional sports na magsimula. Kasi sa professional sports, hindi naman po natin ipagkait sa kanila yung hanap buhay nila. So, they were able to continue with their sports. Yun nga lang, they have to be in a controlled environment, especially sa basketball. They have to be in a bubble. Ganun din yung sa football, nagkaroon po sila ng bubble. So, yun po yung update up to now. And for the Philippine Sports Commission part po, ang hinihintay na lang po natin na mabigyan tayo ng go signal para po masimulan natin ang training ng ating Olympic-bound athletes.
Right, sir. Ano naman po ang ginawa ng inyong ahensya para matulungan ang mga atletang Pilipino, sir?
No training, no allowance. So definitely, hindi po nakapag-training lahat ng atleta, but we see to it that they're in a safe place po. So nagkaroon po sila ng home training program, at yun po yung naging basehan natin, pati yung mga allowance nila. At the same time, even some of our athletes were part of our frontliners. Some of them kasi are enlisted personnel ng Armed Forces of the Philippines, Philippine National Police and Coast Guard. We still monitor them, make sure na okay po sila. At so far, wala pa naman tayong cases na grabbing nagkasakit. Although merong, of course, mga frontliner natin, I cannot tell how many, pero meron po tayong nagkaroon ng asymptomatic na na cases. Although okay na po sila, resolved case na po sila, pero we were able to monitor them.
At ngayon nga pong medyo nakakapag-adjust na tayo sa ating sitwasyon. Ano po ang efforts ng inyong ahensya para maipagpatuloy ang training sa games?
Obviously, yung mga individual sports, they have begun, pero controlled pa rin. Of course, they are advised not to expose themselves. They are carefully monitored by their coaches. Ang ating inihintay na lang po, especially for our Olympic-bound athletes, ay mabigyan tayo ng go signal ng IATF, and then we will bring them to a bubble environment, especially our contact sports, and we're planning to bring them to the Inspire Academy in Laguna. So Inspire Academy, nakapag-host na po yan ng bubble doon, so we are very confident that they will be taken care po doon.
Pag-usapan naman natin, sir, itong tungkol sa bill na ipinasa tungkol sa pagbabawal sa mga minors from full contact competitive sports. Sir Mark, ano po ba ang masasabi nyo tungkol dito at ano ba ang mga posibleng maging epekto nito sa larangan ng sports?
Well, at this point in time, hindi po maapektuhan yung sports natin kasi it was just a proposed bill. Kung magiging batas, it will definitely affect the sport. But for the purpose of discussion, kasi it was filed sa Committee of Youth and Sports sa Congress, and we understood the heart of the congressman na nag-file po noon. And we are one with him in protection of our children pag nag-engage sila sa sports. So, nandun po yung mga iba't ibang organization na hawak po ang karate, taekwondo, boxing. And they support naman the drive to protect the athlete. It's just that I think yung title medyo... nakalagay po kasi banning, but if you read the bill, it's more about protection. And sa Congress naman, and we are very fortunate to have a very dynamic members ng Congress sa Youth and Sport. They are actually asking PSC, DepEd, and the different sports association kung ano pa yung pwedeng input nila doon sa batas. So we would like to clarify po na it was just a proposed bill. It's not anything that can affect yung sports natin at this time kasi it was a proposal. And I think the Committee of Youth and Sports is continually gathering information, suggestions, para po ma-improve ang mga, not only this bill, but on the different bills na pwede po nilang ilabas. So, yun na po nakagandahan nung sa Committee of Youth and Sports. They're very open naman to consult with the stakeholders when it comes to drafting a bill po.
At sir, para sa ating mga manonood, meron po ba kayong mga projects and activities ngayong huling buwan ng taon? At ano po ba ang plano ng PSC for this 2021?
A lot of our activities are done online. For the Philippine Sports Commission, we have our online coaching and training. So we have different courses that we have offered. In fact, I think we're finishing up with the first round of our courses. So ang nakagandahan din time na to kasi we were able to have more participants kasi online nga. Whereas kung actual, you know, some of them might have to travel to Manila from the provinces. So ang kagandahan kasi ito, it's online. They can do it in their home, they can do it in their office, or they can do it in a coffee shop. And we were able to get a lot more participants, a lot more engagement on the part of PSC po.
Sir Mark, mensahe na lang po para sa ating mga ka-schoolmates.
Well, on the part of the Philippine Sports Commission, we are, of course, in celebration of the upcoming holidays or in Christmas season, we wish everyone a Merry Christmas. And I know we know that it's been a difficult year. Everybody has been affected. And on behalf of the Philippine Sports Commission, we would like to remind yung mga kababayan natin, especially mga kabataan, to stay safe and keep yourself healthy po. So, yun lang po.
Maraming salamat po, Sir Mark ng Philippine Sports Commission. Tutok lang kayo guys para sa iba pang hatid namin sa inyo sa pagbabalik ng Schoolmates!
Nagbabalik ang Schoolmates, guys! we all know na having a school garden is a common project sa mga paaralan, which is very beneficial to the students. Para nga naman matuto sila ng mga garden works at kung paano magtanim at alagaan ang mga gulay na kanilang kakainin. Nais ko ibahagi sa inyo ngayon ang tungkol sa proyekto na isang paaralan sa General Santos City na nagbibigay tulong maging sa mga magulang ng mga mag-aaral. This is very notable, guys, kasi alam naman natin, di ba, napakahirap na sitwasyon ngayon ng mga pamilya given the pandemic. Palayan sa paaralan, yan ang tawag sa proyekto sinimulan ng Dato Akadalid Elementary School Principal na si Sir Lou Bernardino. Noong taong 2013, nang simulan ni Sir Lou ang proyekto na ito, katuwang niya ang mga farmer parents upang mapakinabangan ang bakanting lupain sa likod ng kanilang paaralan. Nakapag-ani ang income-generating project na ito nang hindi bababa sa 90 na sako ng palay na kamakailan lang ay umabot na nga daw ng 100 sako. Ang kita nila rito ay pinaghahatian ng paaralan at farmer parents na nagsisilbing tulong sa kanilang pamilya. Bukod sa nakakatulong ito sa kita ng mga magsasaka, nagbunga rin ng magandang samahan, pagmamahalan at pagkakaisa ang inisyatibong ito ni Sir Lou. So, kudos po kay Sir Lou para sa pag-iisip ng ganitong klaseng initiative, di ba, guys?
Yan ang totoong hashtag plantito.
At true! Bilang
pero
ito,
palay.
Pero palay, oo.
Ang saya, di ba?
Tsaka maganda yun, nakabataan habang bata, ini-involve na sa agrikultura.
Oh. Yeah, and they appreciate more what they eat, di ba? Vegetables, lalo na yung kanin, yung bigas na kinakain. And to give respect to our farmers, to give them what they deserve and more, di ba? Bilang silang nagbibigay sa atin ng makakain.
Saka, di ba, nakikita natin dito na hindi dapat talaga sayangin yung kinakain natin kasi napakahirap talaga naman sa aspeto ng agrikultura na, kumbaga, from the part na tinanim nila hanggang sa makarating sa tables natin, napakahabang proseso. And it's really good na nabibigyan ng opportunity yung mga kabataan na maintindihan yung entire na process na to.
Right. And speaking sa mga kabataan natin, di ba, itong mga kabataan, kina Sir Lou ay nabibigyan nila importansa ang ating kinakain. Dumako tayo sa ibang mga kabataan. Ito, pinag-usapan natin ang mga minor de edad na nais ipagbawal ang kanilang pagsali sa mga full contact sports o ito yung mga physically taxing na mga sports. Ako, ang personal kong pananaw dito is siguro kasi alam ko may mga bata eh. When I was in school, kayo din siguro mapapansin nyo, may mga taekwondo trainings na nagsisimula yan ng kabataan nila, judo, etc.
Basketball even.
Yeah,
medyo close contact sports.
Meron siyang, hindi siya ma-consider as full contact, but it's physically taxing.
Yes.
Talagang maaaring magkaroon ng physicalan or physical pain na mangyari. So I think tama yung i-regulate muna nila kung paano gagawin yung mga trainings for these sports. Pero huwag sanang tanggalin sa mga kabataan itong pagkakataon na may matutunan silang mga mga sports.
Mm-hmm.
And with them learning this, di ba, ang natututunan din nila dito, disiplina, paano makipagkapwa, makipagtulungan. It's more than just knowing how to kick and punch.
Mm-mm.
It's the discipline na ini-instill natin sa ating mga kabataan. So sana mas pag-ingatan na lang natin when we do the trainings, pag-ingatan ng mga coaches, ng mga institusyon that teach and train our youth. So ayun, kayo, what do you guys think about this topic?
Ako hindi ako eksperto sa usapin ng palakasan ng sports. Pero kaugnay nung nasabi ni Sky.
Tayong tatlo naman.
Oh. De ako, dun niya, kaugnay sa sinabi ni Sky. Bilang isang batang atleta, nung ako yung nasa elementarya,
are you
were? Taekwondo at saka basketball.
Sample niya, pa isang sipa.
Yeah, sa taekwondo at saka basketball, parang para sa akin, itong ang mainit na usapin ng paghahain ng House Bill 1526, hindi ba't parang mas delikado kung isasalang mo agad ang isang atleta sa edad na 18, di ba, ng biglaan? Hindi ba't mas maganda kung mas matagal yung ensayo? Kasi ang katawan natin at ang ating motor skills ay nag-a-adapt.
Diba? No, but Gab, kasi i-regulate lang din nila yung training. It doesn't mean they can't go into training prior to that. It's just that they can only enter the competition once they reach 18. So yung gagawin nila, di ko alam nga kung paano yung regulation na nais dito sa House Bill, hindi siya explicated masyado. pero meron aalaw nila yung training but it's regulated. So yun din yung tanong ko, how this will be regulated. So sana talaga matutukan yung pag-regulate. Pero kasi maganda nga na ma-instill pa rin yung training sa kanila earlier on para mas maganda yung sabak nila.
Okay, so sana maging klaro yan dun sa naging panukala. And sabi nga kanina nung sa PSC ni Attorney Iroy, isa sa mga representante dyan sa Philippine Sports Commission, sa ibang bansa, ang baseball daw ang isa sa pinaka-prone sa injury na sport at hindi contact sport. So, kinakailangan dyan ng mas mahabang pag-aaral. That's why we urge our lawmakers at ang mga eksperto na to carefully deliberate this bill at maging siguro tulad ng nabanggit kanina ni Sky. Sana yung definitely poprotektahan natin ang mga menor de edad.
Right. That's
dapat
even goal natin.
Magkaroon ng klarong panuntunan at sistema kung lalo na sa usapin ng consent pagdating sa contact sports. Pero wag lang tayo aabot sa punto na tayo mismo yung pumipigil sa oportunidad para mas hubugin pa natin ang mga kabataang atleta sa larangan ng palakasan.
Ikaw bilang a human kinetic
true
today sa iyong outfit.
Oo, Merry Christmas sa lahat. Actually, Gab and Sky, yung nakita ko agad doon sa topic natin is, ang unang nga pumasok sa utak ko ay, talaga bang ano, is this really a concern already in the sports community?
Yeah.
So, I think of it as a good way na maraming mga kabataan ang interesadong pumasok sa ganitong klase ng sports. But at the same time, parang kung titignan mo rin yung perspective ng isang magulang, kailangan din talaga yung pag-iingat. Kaya tama din talaga yung kailangan i-regulate yung pagpapanukala ng batas na to. Kasi hindi lang naman mga bata to eh. Kumbaga may future naman din, ano eh, other than, may future beyond the sports. Kasi they are only there for
it's just merely protecting their interests.
True. Diba? And they can no longer perform kung at such a young age, they will be damaged agad.
Physically.
Diba? So physically. Oh. So hindi lang naman to sa aspeto na kung ikaw ay magpapatuloy bilang atleta until the end of your age. But then, it's also about protecting what you can still do as a child.
Right.
So, kailangan talaga is protektahan natin yung interest ng mga kabataan. E at the same time, hindi dapat natin nililimitahan
balance
kung ano yung kaya nilang gawin given na they have already shown interest at this early age, di ba? So, syempre, dahil usapin mga kabataan ngayon, di ba? Mamaya na, ay, actually, mamaya ba? Next episode pa pala. Nadami pa tayong pag-uusapan, guys. And with that, sabat usapin, sabat issue, may boses tayo, mga kabataan.
Sumali, makinig at makisa dahil opinion nyo'y mahalaga.
Kaya naman, sabay-sabay nating isigaw sa buong mundo. Schoolmates,
may pakialam ka!